Hello.
Oh, hey, puppy.
I can't pet you. I would love to. You look very pettable, but just not a good idea.
Well, if you couldn't tell, we're in a village right now in the middle of the Amazon. We got some nice puppers and some nice village livers, folk that live here or something. You guys get what I'm saying. But look at all this. We got a nice village here. We're gonna do a little village exploration. Apparently you can, you know, find some cool things. You can trade them some knives. I lost one knife, throwing a spear. Didn't work. But I've got one more, like, utility, multi-purpose tool. So, I think I'm gonna see if I can trade for something cool. Well, hey, pup. It's okay. I literally cannot touch you. Do not bite me. If you bite me, we're gonna have an issue. Okay, be nice. Right here, we got a traditional soccer field. Look at this. They literally just mowed. I don't even know what they used to mow. Probably some type of weed whacking tool, whatnot. Maybe they just, well, I don't know. It actually looks pretty decently cut, but goalpost, everything. Oh, hey, pup. Hey, how's it going? How you doing? Yeah, you're my friend. I know. It's okay. All right, you tell him. You tell him. Well, this is pretty cool. Soccer field. I mean, then they got, I think there's a school. There's got to be a school here. And then some houses, and I don't know. We're just going to walk around and see what we find. So right here, it looks like they got some type of way to capture water. So there's, I don't know what type of tree this is. It looks like a palm tree type deal. And the rain falls off the leaves. And they have a giant bucket. It's like the buckets you see at water parks that dump. It's like one of those, but it doesn't dump. Then they hooked up piping that comes all the way down. So the pipe comes down and then it goes to the houses to run water. So that's how they have running water here. It's through this. That's actually really clever. They put it right above some type of tree that I don't know if it filtrates it or just kind of collects it or whatnot, but this place is nuts. Look at this, the post they have for electricity. I think that's electricity because it looks like there's a generator. Looks like a generator in there. Electricity, that's their telephone wire looking thing that they literally just made out of a tree. Absolutely unreal, folks. We are climbing down the hill here. These little kids, there's two of them, and we're gonna give them some Coke that we have with some cans of Coke that we were supposed to have for lunch we didn't have, so we're gonna give them to these guys. We don't have much to give them, unfortunately. You know, I came here, I was gonna trade them some pocket knives for some cool things, but there's nothing really here for us to trade them, so we're just gonna give them some Coke and hopefully that makes their day a little bit better, I guess. It's cool to see this, but at the same time, it's depressing because this is their everyday life. I mean, it's a little bit brutal, but they don't know any difference. So if there's anything we can do to make it a little bit better, like, you know, giving them a Coke, it's definitely well worth it. Yeah. Need any help? Can I help you?
I can help you. This right here? Oh, Christ, I did it the wrong way.
There you go, buddy.
There you go.
Good.
Let me see.
Good? Yeah. Nice.
It's good? Yeah.
Just put it all the way.
Give me five.
Put it all the way.
Broken Portuguese.
Look at that. You got one stick. Freaking jaguar, dude. That's awesome. That is nuts.
Adios. Well, the broken Portuguese, I basically just spoke Spanish and hoped that it worked. Saw the pelt of a jaguar. And then we gave her out like eight Cokes to the people here. But look at these guys. All right, we're finally leaving this village. Saw a jaguar pelt. Gave the kids some sodas. Saw some amazing things, but time to get back on the boat.
A few moments later.
Oh, hell yeah, that's what I like to see.
Just an absolute freaking hurricane coming our way.
It's coming down now, boys!
You gotta love it, folks. I mean, we are in the rainforest in the Amazon, but hadn't seen this quite yet. After a long day in the heat, actually feels pretty good, but not fishing, not fishing. How you feeling this morning, Ricky? Well, folks, as you can tell, it is the next day. We are about to go fishing. As you saw, it rained an absolute ton. We saw the village, which was absolutely incredible. And then basically we just
we were literally about to go fishing and it started downpouring, as you guys saw. So we came back here and it rained all night. We had dinner and just chilled. I didn't really film any of that because I figured you guys maybe won't think that's super interesting, us eating dinner and stuff. But now it's the next day. We got to bed early, dude. We went to bed at like 10. Mm-hmm. So we're rested. We are rested and ready to go. It's about 6 a.m. right now. We're going to go out. We're going to eat some breakfast and then go peacock bass fishing. I still haven't caught a big one. John caught a 17, and that's making me want to catch a big one. You got the gator necklace
on. Got my
good
luck on.
Basically, just a cool necklace. Anyways, I'm going to shut up. We got to go catch some Mondo peacock bass. Gentlemen, day has been a struggle. Started off the day just chopping, chopping, and chopping. John and I have been chopping our freaking arms off all stinking day. No action whatsoever, nothing at all. Literally didn't even get a single explosion or anything. So I ended up switching to the hair jig, which is what I caught that last spotted peacock bass on. Sun's starting to kind of come out. It's coming in and out right now. But as the sun comes out, maybe we'll start getting more bites. I mean, we can't really get any less bites than we've gotten. We haven't really had much, but show you the hair jig that I'm throwing. It's this guy. It's actually pretty big. Once you put it in the water, it kind of spreads out a little bit. It looks like a little parrot swimming through the water, which I'm sure that's not what it's trying to imitate, but that's just an update for you guys. Still looking for the big fish. Chippity chippity chop. Ooh, all right. Just made a move back to some shallow water. This is like way different than anything we've seen yet. This is where all the water dragon boys need to come back, because right now it's, I don't know, what do you think, 3.5, maybe 4 feet max, and it's like really, really clear. It's got the little stain to it as far as like color of the water goes, but you can see the bottom. So we're gonna chuck this chopper out there, because if there's fish here in this shallow water, they're gonna be eating. There's no other reason why they'd be this shallow.
Oh,
jig. No, throw in. Dude, giant fish. Dude, it's a giant. I literally was banging against that brush. Yeah, yes. I ran it into the bush and he tried to eat it out of the bush. Oh. Big swirl. Big fish. Dude, it ate it when I was in the leaves. I was stuck in leaves and it same thing. I'm getting stuck in something that's trying to eat it. This little place we found is absolutely loaded with giant fish, but they're just not eating it in the open. You know, they're just doing giant swirls when you're kind of jiggling around in a bush or stuck in a leaf. It's not a typical hit. So I don't know, thinking about a slow rolling spinner rate through this stuff. I don't know if that would help, but they're just not eating it at the right time.
Oh, all right. Necesito grande pesca, eh?
Sí.
See, yeah, we need big fish. Had two massive blow-ups as I was literally getting my chopper stuck. It was weird. It was like it would get in the bush and they would just boil, but they wouldn't blow up like they're eating it. It's just like almost just spooked them out of the bush. And I kept throwing the jig in there. I probably should have thrown the spinnerbait, but we got to move. We got to find some more spots. That's a good sign. That's the most action John and I have really had all day today as far as just giant fish blowing up on top water. I don't know. Maybe late morning type deal. Not really sure. But we're gonna move spots. Gotta find big old Bertha. What do you think, Johnny?
Necesito grande pescado.
Si.
Oh, got him.
Got him?
Yep, got one.
Big one?
No, just a little guy. Keep tension on. Oh golly. Alright, there he is. Okay.
Get him out of here, boy. Get him in here, boy.
I got the fish, but I got a tree, so I gotta figure this out.
Look at that little guy.
This is what happens when I fish with this guy. This is what happens, guys. I catch a fish like this, but this is my first of the day. So finally on the board, this thing is beautiful. This is a spotted peacock. Nice dorsal, nice little dot right there on the tail, but gorgeous. Big one, big one, big one, dude, giant, giant. Oh God, he got me around the bush. It's a tank. It's a, dude, it's massive. It's massive. It's massive. He's got me around that last bush. Dude, it's so big. Big fish. Oh, come on, stay out of there. Stay out of there. I can't get him out. Come on.
Big fish?
Big fish. Big fish. Big fish. Big fish.
Big
fish. Big fish. Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Big fish.
Oh my God. I can't believe I got this sucker out of the trees. Oh my gosh. Come on. Come on. Come on. Oh no no, come on! Oh no, he's coming. No 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 no! Don't do this on me! Don't do this on me! Woo! There we go! Big fish.
Good.
Big fish. Oh my goodness! I don't know how that sucker didn't come off. I have no idea how that didn't come off. He had me around 9 different trees. Look at that, baby! Oh, what an absolute tanker. By far my biggest one of the trip.
Big fish.
I just threw it in the trees, and on the fall, it smoked it. And when I set the hook, it ran me around every single tree back there. I have no idea how I landed that sucker. That's a big one.
18 pound.
What is it?
18 pound.
18?
18 pound.
In the arms of the angel, fly away from here.
Well, adios, fish. 18? 18, 1-8. 1-8.
18 pound.
18. 18.
Big brother, 20 pound, big brother.
There's big brothers, 20 pounds.
20 pound, big
brother. What the hell?
Good.
That beats my PB by 11 pounds. 11 pounds. I didn't think it was that much. 18 pounds. Was that speckle?
Speckles.
Mm-hmm. That was a speckled peacock. Mm-hmm. 18 big pounds. Food. Oh, we should have got measurements on it. Oh, man, folks. It has been a long, stinking day. But look at this view. You can't get mad when the view looks like this. Absolutely gorgeous out here in Brazil. I had a great time. It sounds like the guys were on the struggle bus today. Sounds like they may have only caught a couple fish. A lot of them were small. And I just so happened to catch my PB of 18 pounds. Absolutely incredible. Didn't get a hold of it very long. I did take some photos with it, and then the guy weighed it and released it. Not really knowing that I wanted to, you know, get some measurements on it for a potential mount. You know, not an actual mount, but like a replica. But it's okay. I ain't even worried about it. I just gotta catch a bigger one. That's all that really matters. But again, I had a good time. John caught his PB the other day, 17 pounds. I just caught mine today, 18 pounds. And it sounds like the next biggest fish maybe is like 13 or 14. So right now, John and I are just breaking the myth of the flare fish. The flare fish rule does not apply here in Brazil, in South America. It's only a US thing. So overall, it was a good day, had a great time. But let me know in the comment section down below, do you guys enjoy these series where, you know, we just do something completely off the wall, like travel to the Amazon and catch peacock bass? Or do you just like, you know, the pond fishing videos? Or do you like kind of a mixture? And if you like a mixture or you like these series, let me know where else I need to go. What other species should I target? Whether it's hunting, fishing, what country should I go to? How should I catch them? I need help. I need help from you guys letting me know where I should go, what I should do next. Doing these trips like this is awesome. I absolutely love it. It's a super fun time. Just completely just takes me out of my element. You know, I get to hang out with cool people from a different culture, even though I can't really understand them, they can't understand me. It's still fun to interact with them. It is a great time. And so far, I'm absolutely loving my trip.
here in Brazil. Like I said in the previous videos, if you guys want to come do this, I will leave a link in the description on how you can book a trip, do exactly what I'm doing right now, and keep in mind the fishing's the worst it's ever been according to the people that have already been here, like Winston, the guides, everybody's saying this is the worst the fishing has ever been because of the high water. It's not because this place sucks, it's the high water. And I still got an 18 pounder, John caught a 17. I mean, to me, it's great, but everybody else is saying this is nothing. So if you guys do want to come check it out, links down below, you guys can come and join. Maybe me, I think I'll probably come back here every year. I don't see why not. I'm absolutely in love with this place. But if you guys enjoyed, let me know, drop a comment down below. Make sure you hit the subscribe button. Peace.